Hi, I'm Peter Travers, movie critic for Rolling Stone, here to tell you what's going on at the movies, and big going on is Kick-Ass.
Oh yeah, didn't see that, did you?
Kick-Ass is the graphic novel, it's Mark Miller. It's a kind of movie that Hollywood usually screws up in major ways, so you know what? Hollywood didn't do it. A Brit director, Matthew Vaughn, did it. He only had $30 million, which I have to tell you, in Hollywood, is chump change. That's like Brad Pitt's budget for lunch. This wasn't done with money, so they could have an R rating for this. And the R rating really pays off. Aaron Johnson, who you don't know because he's a British actor, but he's playing this American kid called Dave Wazowski. He is going to be kick-ass because he's just this nerdy kid. He always gets kicked around, and he decides to go on the internet, buy himself a green wetsuit that's horribly ugly, and call himself kick-ass. And he can't do anything. He has no superpowers. He can't do crap. But because of MySpace, because of YouTube, because of everything else, he becomes somebody. He becomes famous. And then other people get involved. Who are the other people? Well, Christopher Mintz-Plasse, who we all know as the iconic McLovin from Superbad. He's got this gangster father, and he decides to call himself Red Mist. And this is McLovin playing Red Mist. But instead of just doing the joke and the nerdy kid, he's a tough kid. And then comes the toughest kid of all, played by an actress who's 13 years old, named Chloe Grace Moretz. And this performance as hit girl in this movie is so good, your head will come off when you see her. It already has come off from a lot of the Christian right. If you've looked at the Red Band trailer for Kick-Ass, we get to see scenes where Chloe Moretz playing the 11-year-old girl whose father, played by a completely deadpan and insane Nicolas Cage, which is the best Nicolas Cage for me, trains her to kill. He wants revenge on whoever killed his wife and her mother. And she has these rotary blades and she's killing people, but she also comes out, as she does in the Red Band trailer, and starts to say things, what are you, C-word, which I call see you next Tuesday, what are you gonna do about it? She also talks about the signal the mayor has to call her to help, which is in the shape of a giant.
It's in the shape of a giant cock.
This is not your typical PG-13 Hollywood movie. This really pushes it. And does it go off the rails once in a while? It sure does. But it has energy. It has style. It actually works. You get a new star in Chloe Moretz. You get Christopher Mintz-Plasse actually being terrific and sad and funny because this father goes to the little girl and says, why can't I have a son like you? So we see the broken places of these characters. We actually see a comic book come to life in a vivid way. Listen to me. I'm talking about one movie. I'm not telling you about the other crap that's out there because Kick-Ass is definitely the movie that you need to see. Now, the other big movie out there, they're not showing me, and not just because of me, but any critics. It's called Death at a Funeral. It was a British movie a couple of years ago, and now it's with Tracy Morgan and Chris Rock. Lots of African-American actors. In fact, Chris Rock said anybody that's not in the new Tyler Perry movie is in this movie. The trailer looks like, oh God, it looks awful, but I will go see it. I will pay my money and come back and tell you what it is. I'm not gonna use my get out of jail card for it. I'm just gonna say, I will go. But what you need to do is to see Kick-Ass, because it really does. I'm Peter Travers.